Today we're going to be working on the stained glass inspired nail design. For this design, I'm using this plate. Today I'm going to be using this plate. This is the Queen 104, and it comes in this collection, which is the Make Your Day 24M. I'm also going to be using black stamping polish from Queen. You're going to need your scraper and stamper. I'm using a clear jelly today. You can also use some latex liquid tape for around your cuticle if you want to just help with cleanup. You're going to need rubbing alcohol and acetone to clean up. You're also going to need your polishes. Today I'm using DIY or Die Hard Nails, and I'm using the base top coat. And then the color that I chose to use today was Galaxy Twilight, which is this beautiful glittery purple, blue, and silver color. You're also going to need your LED or UV lamp and paper towels to clean up. So let's go ahead and get started with this nail design. Go ahead and start by applying your base coat. You want to do thin, even layers, making sure to cure. Go ahead and apply 2 to 3 coats of your color. Today I'm using Galaxy Twilight, which is a glitter polish. You're going to want to use a glitter polish to get that stained glass effect. Once you get the color built up, go ahead and remove the tacky layer with rubbing alcohol. I use 91%. So for today's stamping, I'm going to be using Queen 104. I'm also going to be using their black polish. I'm going to be using this design here. I'm going to be using a clear jelly stamper scraper set. And then just around my cuticles, I have some of this, which is a latex barrier, just to help with cleanup. If you don't have that, of course, you can just use acetone. So I'm just going to run through real quick what I'm going to do, because once I start the stamping, I'm going to have to move fairly quickly. So I'm going to place down the polish. I'm going to scrape it and then pick it up with the stamper. And then I'm going to place it on the nail, and you can see, as you can see, this is clear, so I'm able to see where I want to place it and hopefully get it somewhat centered. In between each pass, I'm going to be making sure to clean my plate with acetone and also clean off my stamper. Once you have the stamping done, go ahead and apply your top coat.